Hey, Mikey Turbos, going to B&H again.
17 minutes.
Day.
Have a good day.
Bye now.
Are you about to be
the man? Yeah, buddy. We in the city. Going to B&H. Doing it again. Oh, hey, how you doing? So we're here at B&H, and I'm looking at lenses today. This here is the Sony 35mm, I believe. Yes, this is the Sony with the OSS. I've been saying I wanted to get a prime lens for this camera. So I'm gonna check out the Sony first, and then Sigma. I'm kind of leaning towards the Sigma because, first of all, yes, this has OSS, but the Sigma doesn't, but you don't really need it because this already has IBIS. Whatever it's called.
Let me see the lens.
This is really light.
Do you need help, sir?
We're shooting now on the
Sony. See Gina. I have other pictures, 4 or 5 pictures.
Oh, that bokeh.
There, any place you want.
Wow, this is, you can actually get pretty close. I didn't think you can get that close.
Big Sony booth over
here. Where?
The zoom was really good. Look at that. Now, I don't think I'll be able to do this. Too close?
Yeah, that's what they did. That movie, Sky Can World Tomorrow, was almost entirely done.
So this is the lens here, the Sigma, which I'm leaning more towards, and let's check it out.
This money is evidently being spent in the A7 movie. They just introduced another camera, unfortunately lenses, only one new lens last year.
Wow.
Evidently, companies are not interested in spending money. They could have done a better job than Sony would.
Yeah. Okay, this is being shot on a Sigma. Wow, that's really sharp. And I can get in a little bit closer because this is a 30mm, so it's equivalent to 45, while the other one's equivalent to a 52.
Very good. He knows the aspect ratio.
Yeah, I've been.
Which most people look at and say, what the hell is this?
Right, I've been looking it up, trying to figure it out. So here you can see the beautiful bokeh behind it. And that focus is actually pretty good. And you know what? The stabilization is fine for me. It's not like I'm going to be walking around with it anyway. I'm going to be having it on a tripod. So right now I'm at a 2.2 aperture. So that's pretty good. This is great for low light. With a very low aperture. Wow, that focus, man. This is amazing. You're really close up, too.
Hello.
Like, that's pretty close up.
It's a memory card and the card reader.
How does it look if I'm...
Well, it focuses, absolutely.
Yeah?
A lot of bokeh.
That's awesome.
How did this one work compared to this?
I like it, this one a lot more. It's a lot more sharp.
Smile? Going to photo mode. What do you think? Hey, get me. Like, if I'm standing right here, right?
That's professional.
You see? Yeah. See how that's...
Right.
Did you even touch the screen to focus?
No.
I say get this one.
Batteries for
this
whole
Dimash
camera.
Oh, that's good.
You like it? You want to take some test shots with this one?
Look how sharp that is.
You want to take some test shots with this?
Yes.
If it hasn't been charged in months, it will degenerate. It's probably the lead.
The one you have.
It's probably most likely the lead.
So how do they know when you're buying these used batteries? How do you know how long they've been sitting there?
I don't like that it's sounding very snug.
What? It's supposed to.
Yeah, but that one doesn't snap on.
So which one's more zoomed in, this one or the other one?
This one. I think the colors are better on the Sigma.
I personally like Sigma.
Yeah. So you can see a slight difference in skin tone. A little bit more whiter in this one, but this one looks a little bit more natural.
And Sigma's cheaper too?
Yeah, that's a $330. This is like $450. Something
like that. Do you still have the memory card?
Yeah, I got it. There's a machine that spends a memory card there.
Oh, really?
It's about 2 times the rim.
Yeah.
You can actually get a nice camera.
And now we're showing you with my regular lens that I always use.
Yes. Want to back up?
No, I'm good.
It's
wide.
No, only one.
Of course, you can zoom in on my. This is the lens I regularly use. No, it's not focusing. I'm not too concerned about this lens because this is my main lens. The prime lens I'm mostly going to use for my green screen work. Well, I don't always have to use it for that. I could use it for anything else that I want, but I got 2 cameras going.
You got 2 views.
So I think I'm going to get the Sigma. Not today though. I got to wait until I get paid. But
I would have to see what that is.
So the main verdict
so I should bring it in to see
is the Sigma.
Right.
Yep.
Dragstad has a different franchise than I do. This is actually a very common thing.
Yeah?
People are actually coming to take pictures and movies is something they're planning on buying.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir.
I wanted to make sure I'm getting the right lens that I want. I don't want to just buy it and find out. I don't like it.
Well, your choices are few, especially ones that have autofocus. Most of them don't even have autofocus.
Right. So here we're looking at this new Sony 6400. And this is the one where the screen flips out like this. It's pretty cool.
I don't care for it.
No? I don't like this hinge here. I see what you mean now.
Yeah.
And you couldn't put your mic here.
I'd rather keep it 6500.
Yeah. Wow, that startup is really quick. I also don't like that it got rid of the custom. The custom 1 and 2, because I use that a lot. I hope you can see that in the camera.
The screen's nice, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
But I still rather have.
I feel like that's very easy to break.
Yeah.
God forbid you drop it, that's it. I mean, it's basically the same camera, just with a flip screen and a few things changed. That's the Sony X6400.